Trevor came in first, he's kind of an unassuming guy. He came in and sat down in the corner and, you know, get about his business. But over the years, he became a leader.
Here's Trevor Giles, onto his left boot.
He was a gentleman off the field. He was well able to fight his own corner, but he concentrated on playing football.
I was insecure growing up, naturally shy, still don't enjoy public speaking or getting up in front of people. Football would have improved that so much with me.
Trevor Giles can be so influential.
If that dim Leona, by Trevor Giles and Chiru Rivik food in the me, how Kurumviki did ash between Hyundai Ryoga, free host Nonechadi. Hishro, crave Minuru Ruch into Nechado, via debut Lesh Nashinch Rega, in Lidig Necha Ked. Agus near Shawad, go worship Lasha, gonna do line of wine and Lesh and Bell Edir Hyundai. Farog, like namely on the dig, Agus Agluffy Canish Lion.
The pace of that game was like nothing I'd come across before. The intensity of it, the time on the ball, or the lack of time on the ball. Struggled that day, which I was hard on myself for. And with looking back, you're 19, you're very young, you're playing at the very, very highest standard.
I remember standing on Hill 16 and in some ways kind of feeling for this young lad being thrown into the Lions den. Like anything, it takes a while to adapt to senior inter-county football, and he would have learned a hell of a lot over those few years in those debacles with Dublin.
It's a Dublin are the champions! The 3 in a row from Dublin!
Chas na fór near the chéile rís de Lion an eich a cúg, agus is mass an bóla fud in vi in Warsha. Bi fud an eintoch na mi, a grú gách raif ille éirin fi chan bailin a galileig.
Probably the mix wasn't just right that year, through no fault of anyone. Just maybe some of the younger lads were a little too young, some of the older lads were maybe a little too old, you know.
I think that 95 game, you know, certainly Dublin coming through by 10 points, you know, Dublin were never in that position coming into a game against Mead. Everybody left Croke Park that day probably thinking that great Mead team that had been dominant from the late 80s right through the early 90s, a lot of people probably thought they were gone for a few years and would take them a time to rebuild.
Is it the end of the road for Sean Boylan and this Mead team?
Well, I don't suppose, Mary, that's something you never think about, but maybe some of us are gone past the sell-by date.
There was talk about Sean stepping down, all right, and the younger players like Trevor that were pushing for Sean to stay because the experience was there and they felt that they needed somebody there that knew what needed to be done to win All-Ireland.
I rang Sean to give him my support, felt he was the right man to lead us. I didn't feel the blame lay in any way at Sean's door. So we got the job anyway, survived the vote. But yeah, it was a watershed moment. We had to come back the following year, and you couldn't be beaten 3 years in a row. You couldn't allow it to happen.
I don't think anybody expected them in 96 to bounce back, and Giles was part of a new crew of players. Sean Boylan really brought a new team to Croke Park that year.
Back to Trevor Giles, going and sitting and getting the equaliser.
I was marking Eamon Heary that day. We had a great battle with Eamon, I must say. Now he's a tough player. Graham got hit off the ball early on, and as you do, you tend to head to the scene of the crime. Just as I landed on the scene, I heard Eamon behind me saying, "I'm right behind you, Trevor." So it was as if you do anything here, I'm going to bust you, you know.
There's a lot of good imagery of this sheet in the raw group. Nadine Vinsig Boga on piano, agus Nadine Vinsig Shenna on piano, agus Istoilam Gershentud v. Trevor Giles.
Hits it well, dropping, over the mark.
Certainly for me, I needed to gain some respect from the Mead supporters, or maybe it's the Dublin players. You just needed to prove something that day.
The tension in Croke Park is truly amazing.
I just made a decision, whatever I could do in my power to try and win the game, I did it.
Trevor Giles to Brendan Riley, gets a boot to it and puts it over the bar. Trying to find a little bit of room, Desi Farrell bursting his way past the goal, up to him.
Trevor Giles really has been outstanding in terms of work rate from start to finish.
They got hammered last year in the Leinster final by 10 points. They've been talking about it since. They can now talk about this one.
And you've grown up seeing Meath teams beat Dublin. You just wanted to emulate those players, be put in the same bracket as them.
The dethroning of the All-Ireland champions Dublin and Meath being crowned Leinster champions.
I think that win over Dublin in 96 gave Meath huge momentum and huge confidence going forward.
Agus Blackley a bulti fu Jacob, nira ach ein chlifu uvoan idirin vi agus chlifu canish na haidon. Hug sia da iet hidon, agus vi sia tassi.
Tyrone were famous to win the Lurin that year. They would have been, I suppose, the people's favourite really, and Meath wouldn't have any love probably outside Meath at the time.
I would describe Meath as hard. I do remember there was a fallout at the time that Tyrone felt that Meath had kicked them off the park.
So now a total of five players have had their names taken, three from Meath, two from Tyrone.
I suppose the thing that might have been forgotten about that game, we scored 2:15 and 2:13 of it was from play.
Trevor Giles gets there well ahead of
Dinna Cune of Yon. Istoinam Gurchaurish Ashinlesh. There's been still Gimmers Clehimora being Nyart Kinal Passion on. There's Vishesh and the Stoilam Manan Chassis Sheer Waishin. Agus Evanan Nikinich Shahogal Eden Yerod.
Great play between Geraghty and Trevor Giles.
He had this great way of being able to get an extra second. It looked like he'd a lot of time on the ball, but he actually didn't.
And Trevor Giles tries to get it on the left boot. And it's another one.
The bar had raised, you were now thinking not just to win Leinster, you were thinking we've a chance to win in All-Ireland.
Graham Geraghty to round off the day perhaps, Barry Callaghan, and that's it.
Muio vi lohubs a glyphicanish, ach has da ahemurst, agus quimnin gulior ir glyphishin, ach ni maial ir chaid an a pelefakas.
Yeah, it kicked off, and I suppose we all joined in.
You know, I think every manager said one in, all in, and that was it.
My goodness, that really is ridiculous.
You have to be honest about it, we all love a little bit of a dust up.
Well, they all got involved. Some of them are still involved, just to the right of picture.
In fairness, it did look bad. When you look back on it, it looked terrible.
Vi job on Jackerig Pat McEnany and Lawson, mar vi chulogan eg thread, agus istoilam gra ed berth defeca.
Referee is speaking to Colin Coyle, Liam McHale, and they are both being sent off. It seems. Oh, sensation of sensations here.
But the only thing I'd say is that, like, once the row was over, there wasn't any hassle afterwards in the game, and fellas had got everything off their chest at that stage.
It's on to Peter Loftus, he's a goal chance, and he's got it! Oh, John Madden coming out, and he hasn't got it! Oh, it's across the line, and the referee's saying that it's a penalty, I think.
You're 6 points down, you'd been given a penalty, it was a chance for 3 points, you know, so. But nobody ever said, listen, I'll maybe take over here, or nobody put their hands up.
Mayo players trying to put him off, and Trevor, the way he is, he's so calm, you know, put the ball down. And I suppose when you have 64,000 odd people looking at you, and you know you're the centre of attention, you want to score.
Here's Trevor Giles against Bellum, and a brilliant penalty. That was terrific skill.
Probably one of the best penalties I've seen in an All-Ireland final or even Croke Park.
I just aimed it right for the post, and it was only at the last second it just curled inside the post and hit that stanchion at the back.
I don't think the keeper even moved, actually. Fantastic penalty, and really put us into the driving seat.
We came out in the second half, we got some early scores, and clawed back the lead really quickly.
They are just easing into this lead. A goal and 2 points of that tally now for Trevor Giles.
Trevor would be one of the driving forces behind that, because he was out working hard around the middle of the field.
With that wind, now we've got sunshine, still the breeze backing Meath, playing in the gold in the second half, and that's a great kick from Trevor Giles, a goal and 3 points for the young man from Skene.
But we couldn't shake off Mayo, they just kept coming at us and getting scores against the breeze.
And the sides are level, and they're level for just the first time.
Then Colin McMenamin was soloing up the field. Lucky enough, it broke to me. Picked it up and played Brendan Riley. Now, I hit it to the corner flag, which left him a lot to do. It wasn't my intention.
Here's Brendan Riley. Will he be the All-Ireland final hero? Going to set up a chance. The angle shot and it's gone over the bar. Brendan Riley has kicked his first point of the match.
I do remember in the last couple of minutes just thinking to myself, please, please, let me win an All-Ireland. At 21 years of age, to say you'd won an All-Ireland final, you know, and played well, and it was just what you always wanted to do, and you'd finally achieved it.
As GAA president, Jack Boothman, last time he presents the Sam Maguire, and it's to Meath, and it's to Tommy Dowd, and the fans are celebrating.
Gana ach bliana gus fi, enim niu Trevor Giles mar felidur na bliana in luidiag naecha sé. Ach mech Trevor agus an vi, in an na boit céana a wantim achar isht. Is creve na héir na grúch in tine chéise, hú guvali bate agus bohr garu hobe machas in greve na chéise shacht. Ach vlien dar gien, vi kunda na mír éis a glúfi canish lain na naichil dara. Ach berle Trevor dar ma dien er lásin.
I got a lot of great qualities from my mother, but she would say to me after some games, you didn't go for that high ball. And I had her in my mind when the kick out came my way, and I went for it. Now, it was at full stretch, a little bit off balance, caught it. Just came down on the left leg, and off balance, it just gave way underneath me.
Trevor, who is a physiotherapist himself, Sean Boylan coming out there.
I knew something serious had happened, my knee. The main thing I just needed to know whether I still had a career ahead of me.
Ach, I got sheer, chofadale ní diag ní chohocht. Donyana de Cruciate and Thompson.
Came down very heavily on the leg and obviously twisted in landing after making a great catch.
I worked really hard on it. It was really important for me to get back playing with Meath. Probably doing about 4 hours of rehabilitation a day.
You know, being a physio, he knew what had to be done, and he was able to put in the extra work and the proper work, you know. So, you know, I think he came back within 7 months, I think, and was back playing as well as ever.
Once again, Trevor Giles into space towards Graham Garrity.
Vi Trevor Giles dingwalte gwiltice ed id in the me. Agus an oedig yn eichon oi, vi shed eich, the Cliffy Canish Lion, the nine the dubs.
Just out of the blue one Saturday night, it was before that Leinster final in 99. The weather was good at the time, it was going to be a sunny day the following day. Ollie Murphy said it'd be great crack if we went out with sleeveless jerseys tomorrow. Simple as that.
They're all ready to go out, and I think Trevor disappeared to the bathroom and come back out with the sleeves short and put it on and out with him, and I don't think Sean Biden wasn't too happy with him. There was nothing that could be done at that stage. He was trying to set a new trend or redesign the O'Neill's jersey for them.
Probably didn't pay much attention to it, to be honest with you. Probably just encouraged our lads maybe to try and give him a few more clips if we could catch him. But listen, it drew a lot of attention, but it certainly didn't affect his performance.
What a wonderful talent this player is. Incurred a horrific knee injury in last year's Leinster final, but he's back with aplomb.
I suppose we'd been All-Ireland champions in 96, and then we had failed the following 2 years. So I suppose it was a big year for the team. From my point of view as centre forward that year, our full forward name was Ollie Murphy, Graham Garrity and Tommy Dowd. One of those on their own could win a game for you.
Ollie Murphy was one of the key forwards, and he was certainly living off the supply that Giles was supplying out the field.
Chinen on Bua is Moorvig about Brando Suas, I guess, called Goodman Yerot. ke focus me mach.
Simply superb goal. It's all over, and Meath are indeed the Leinster champions for the 19th time.
In the Yeshin, the Bochelinua, Ardwacha Glufilach Anish Nahedon, it was V Trevor Gibbert Homagas of Vishet, three play in the Rivishin, the Rarony of Mar Imnur Napliana, and the Dignacha Shea. Beaches Gurkhaham Vi Ravli and Sawasuk, Vidra Dash, a Glyphic Canish Nahedon and Nahani, Achvekarb Fudin Horka Achli.
Like, we had a good start and we went 1-3 to 2 points up.
Well, he got a great goal early on. I played a long, nice ball to Graham, bit of hang time on it.
Straight after half time, I got fouled for a penalty and Trevor stepped up.
As ever, I got a penalty in an All-Ireland final. My main focus was on hitting the target. In the process, I forgot to hit it with a bit of power or conviction. And it bounced 4 or 5 times before Kevin O'Dwyer picked it up. Not long after that, Joe Kavanagh scored one of the great All-Ireland final goals. Straight away you're thinking, phew, right, possibly going to lose the game here. You're going to be remembered for missing the penalty.
He was very mentally strong and he was confident in his own ability and knew that it would turn for him eventually. Nothing faced him at all. Once, if he missed it, he got on with it. And, you know, for us, he kicked over the couple of frees after and probably sat in the back.
Getting on with things, you know, that was one of Sean's mantras, you know, and he had time to make up for the mistake, to remedy it. But in the last quarter, I won a few breaking balls around the middle of the field, secured possession, got a few balls into Graham, he got a couple of scores.
Cork didn't have that experience coming to Croke Park, you know, they didn't have that big day experience, and I think that shone true for me in the end.
I suppose in 1999 there was no row, there was no controversy. It's great to win one, you know, to win a second backs it up.
He went on to be Footballer of the Year, and I suppose to win Footballer of the Year twice in a 4-year period was a massive achievement.
Blian Elegant Scott, agus ar ish de seir alni of mar felidord na Blianna. Ach níor a sé cléach níhe gom vlíen fós, mar dímur sé leis a vúrion na gymnásiúnta in aina hastrála.
The team that played that night for me was the best team I ever played on. Like, to go out playing on a team like that, you know, just brilliant.
In over the top, however. Canavan's there, picking up the ball, laying it off beautifully. Opportunities for Ireland. And the kick off Brian Stein's boot, over the bar. Over for Ireland. That's great work by Trevor Giles.
Who was a hugely talented group of players and a hugely enjoyable experience. And Giles was one of the main players out on that trip as well. He was one of the leaders. It was a pleasure to get that opportunity to play in the same teams.
A chance for Trevor Giles. Good looking kick. It gets a red flag. Great kick by Trevor Giles. So John McDermott and Colm O'Rourke, captain and coach, take the Coca-Cola International Series trophy back to Ireland.
I ráhílg sa chéan, chidóra Trevor, mar chaibtín, an bhí isteach a glufi leach anis na héidan. Ach má bhí siad le bheith sa glufi canis gan trí uair an achar sé blíana, bheith arb na sempíní wola, Kerry.
The Kerry game, like, it was just a bizarre result. I suppose they were all Ireland champions at the stage, maybe a little bit of their edge or hunger wasn't there.
you know, by the end of the game, it had turned into a bit of a farce to a certain degree with the crowd cheering every pass from Meade.
You know, we beat Kerry in the semi-final with 15 points, and probably that was the worst thing that we could have ever done, because the hype within the county was huge, and we just really had to show up to win that Ireland. That probably got to the players, even though we probably tried not to let it.
And I think it's something you see across all sports, where you see big performances can be followed with a dip. And I think that game, as much as it was a complete performance for Meade against Kerry, it didn't serve them well. They probably went into that All-Ireland final maybe in a little bit of their own comfort zone.
When Kainter fad my all their condemn me, agus Kainter near Howrish as in rope.
Is there support? Does he require it? Stopped by Alan Kay. Here's Paul Canty now, picking on Hank Traynor, showing how it should be done.
Galway were far superior in the second half. Every ball Park Joyce got, he seemed to be able to kick it over.
A decent chance. On his right side, and he has kicked this one, and he's put it over.
First shield kick, Pino, Nomad,
here it comes again. John McDermott's around, and the referee's giving a penalty.
We're 5 points down at this stage, not playing well, things going against us. And I said, okay, now is the time to change my side and go to the other side.
Trevor Giles is going to kick this. Crucial. 5 points between the teams. Maximum concentration.
Vi me hena smino shear er en kipino shohuk sha gunye kunde vio agus vi me long kinte go score al sha on kipino sha.
Giles has got it right. Oh, an amazing miss.
That's one you have to live with. After that call we're done. Won the game by 10 points. To me, if I had scored that penalty, anything could have happened.
Boric Joyce, it's only shooting practice at this stage. It is all over, and Galway on the back of Ireland, All-Ireland football champions from 2001.
The biggest thing after that game, someone told me after that, my mum and dad got a load of abuse during the game from some Meade supporter, and whatever about losing the game, you know, I was really annoyed over my parents having to listen to some clown for a full game, you know. I'd say it's difficult for a parent. What do you say? What do you do? But it's there. It's there in our games, and no matter where you sit, you're probably not far from an individual like that.
Eshin go cion rint blianta shir o chorod igon vi agus a chav ilus a cúg heis chav lian deag sing enzi. Died a Trevor Giles ass and fell Idir Hunde. Chriach na shella bonsraha, 3-1 Lion, Roch Ravel Aidan, agus mar imnur na bliana fwy gho.
I suppose like most Irish fellas, you're insecure. That's the way you grow up, you know, and by winning those things as you go along, you're proving things about yourself, that you can work hard, you can do things under pressure. You know, you come out of the game the far side, I suppose, a more confident person, a bit more secure in your own skin. As much as winning medals, you know, I suppose the game gave me that.
You know, he fully deserved the accolades that he's got. I think he's 3 All-Stars, a Texaco player of the year. He's every honour in the game, really. I suppose that's the just reward you get for the effort you put in, and he probably put in more effort than anybody else.
All round, he was just a real intelligent, smart player who kind of stayed out of the limelight.
As we watch Trevor Giles here.
Knowing that you made some contribution to the success, you know, for your teammates, that you were a good teammate. To the people in the county, you brought them some happiness, you know. That kind of stuff is, you know, I suppose, at the end of the day, the most important.